Shelly Plus H&T is the next generation temperature and humidity sensor that is coming from Alterco Robotics. But what means next generation? Is there anything special in it? What is good and what is bad? Can it work with Home Assistant? I'll try to answer these questions starting right now. Also, watch this video till the end and you'll be able to win a free Shelly Plus H&T delivered to your door as I'm cooking a giveaway here. I will share more info later, as now I'm starting with the Shelly Plus H&T review. Shelly Plus H&T is a Wi-Fi smart humidity and temperature sensor featuring a large e-paper graphic display and powerful ESP32 chip inside. Thanks to that chip, Shelly Plus H&T is also having a Bluetooth that for now is used for inclusion purposes only. But the ESP32 chip is a huge advantage, and because of this chip, Shelly Plus H&T is a second-gen device. The Shelly CEO said that they are working on a firmware that will allow Gen 2 Shelly devices to be used as gateways to other Bluetooth sensors or as a Wi-Fi network extenders, and these things can be a really great benefit. In other words, imagine that your Wi-Fi coverage is not so good in one room of yours, but you want to play some smart Wi-Fi gadgets in that room. No problem, just place one Shelly Gen 2 device, such as Shelly Plus H&T, in the middle between the problematic room and your router, and your problem is solved. The network speed may not be the best in such a scenario, but at least there will be connectivity. Although, during the announcement of the Shelly Plus H&T, they showed that even YouTube videos can be played over the extended network by Shelly Gen 2 devices, which is impressive. I can't wait for that new firmware to be publicly released. Until then, this is just a theory, and who knows if all Gen 2 devices will be compatible with these new cool features. I guess we have to wait and see. Next impressive thing in Shelly Plus H&T is the e-paper, or also known as e-ink display, which is large enough to see it even if you are looking from the glasses made of Coca-Cola bottles. But why such a display is good? Apart from the big numbers that can be easily seen, it has a very low power consumption, and if you ask some e-reader device vendors, they would say that e-paper display is like you are watching real paper and it is best for your eyes. Not that you are going to read books on your Shelly Plus H&T. I can't imagine looking at the device for more than a few seconds, but if something is good for your eyes, then it's good as a whole. Period. By the way, if you want to buy that device, you can use the affiliate links in the video description. That way, I'll receive a small commission from your purchase with no additional cost for you. It is a great way to support this channel overall. The Shelly Plus H&T can be powered by 4 regular AA 1.5 volt batteries that could last over a year. Or you can remove the batteries completely and you can constantly power the device with a tension here, USB-C. I'm wondering when everything will become USB-C. And I'm looking at you, Apple. Never mind, Shelly Plus H&T can be controlled directly and without a hub through your smartphone with Shelly Cloud App or via the integrated web interface. The device can work locally only or with Shelly Cloud or both locally and with cloud. The choice is entirely yours. Of course, as other Shelly products, Shelly Plus H&T is out-of-the-box compatible with Amazon Alexa and Google Home, as well as a bunch of other hubs and protocols like MQTT, REST, and most importantly, with Home Assistant. Important remark here, if you don't have Home Assistant yet, or even worse, you don't know what it is, what are you doing with your life? Go watch my Home Assistant webinar and you understand what are the 4 official methods to get Home Assistant in your home, plus one not so official but stupid easy way to get started in under 5 minutes. The webinar is completely free and you can register on my website automatelike.pro/webinar. I'm waiting you there. Now let's see what is not good about the Shelly Plus H&T. To be honest, there are not so many bad things in my humble opinion. But anyways, here they are. The first thing that I can think of is opening the sensor. It is a nightmare. Everything is so tight, so I have to use a knife and to eventually damage the plastic of the sensor. Thankfully, the opening hole is on the bottom of the sensor and the penetration damage is not visible. Next is the size, which can be considered both as plus or minus, depending on the point of view. If you compare the Shelly Plus H&T to a Xiaomi temperature and humidity Bluetooth sensor, the Shelly looks like a real bulldozer and Xiaomi looks like a toy bulldozer. But again, this is kind of controversial, as the big size can be good due to easy to see numbers, or it can be bad as it can interfere with the feng shui designed room of yours. There is a saying, don't look in the mouth of a gift horse. Or in other words, I can give you a free Shelly Plus H&T no matter you like the device or not. To win the Shelly, you just have to subscribe for my channel and to comment under this video. To make the things even easier for you, I'll ask you a question so you don't have to feel awkward wondering what to say in the comments to participate for the award. So, my question is, do you have any smart temperature and humidity sensors in your home? You can say simple yes or no, or you can give more details. The choice is entirely yours. But again, if you leave any comment and you subscribe, you have the chance to win one Shelly Plus H&T delivered to your door for free. I will announce the winner next Wednesday with my new video, so you have time to comment until Tuesday, end of day. I'm Kirill, I'm done speaking. Bye!